Friends, today we are going to learn about the second year syllabus, Civics 2. So, already we have completed first year, we studied something about the political science, but in the second year we are going to learn completely the Indian politics, the government and politics. So, in the second year, we have 12 concepts. So, they are Indian Constitution and Historical Context, Indian Constitution and Historical Context. Second one is Fundamental Rights and Directive Principles. Fundamental Rights and Directive Principles. Third one is Union Government. Fourth one is State Government. Fifth one is Local Governments. Sixth one is Special Statutory Commissions for Protection of Citizen Rights. And the seventh one is Social Political Movements and Environmental Struggles. Next one is Emergence in Telangana. And the ninth one is Telangana Movement. Political parties and JS. And tenth one is Contemporary Issues. And the 11th one is Smart Governance. And the final and last one is India and the World. So here, dear students, so completely the second year syllabus describes about the Indian politics and the government. So, if we discuss the chapter wise Indian constitution and historical context, the first lesson described about Indian constitution. So, how our Indian constitution was framed, so how many years it takes, and who were written the constitution. So, all these matters we will discuss in the Indian constitution. And at the same time, we will study about the national movement in the first chapter also. So, what is the national movement? What are the major reasons for national movement and stages of the national movement? So, all these points we will discuss in the Indian constitution and under the historical context. The second one is fundamental rights and their principles. So, rights, what is mean by the rights? What are the features of the fundamental rights? So, how many kinds of rights are there? And what are the direct principles of state policy? So, we have six fundamental rights. What are they? So, this is the second chapter, fundamental rights and direct principles. So, direct principles are not just enough. So, just the country provide the principles and implement the principles, but we do not get any justice if the direct principles are not implemented by the government of state or central, but we cannot get any justice for the direct principles. If anybody is violated for the fundamental rights, we will get the justice from the courts. So, this is about the fundamental rights and direct principles. Now, you know very well Union Government. So, Union Government means President of India and Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So, here we discuss about President of India, how he will elect, and President of India, Prime Minister of India, and Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha. So, all these we will learn in the Union Government. Now, next, state government. So, how we are forming the Union Government? As the same manner, we are also forming or setting the state government in our state level. So, central level we have the Union Government, state level we have the state government. So, here we have Governor, Chief Minister, so, member of legislative assembly and member of legislative council, we have bicameralism, means two sabhas. So, now local government. So, India is a democratic country, so that is why we did democratic decentralization. We divide the powers. If we do not divide the powers, automatically it became. So, the government captured all the powers and ruled the people very cruelly. So that is why we divided the governments in the local level also, at the village level, Gram Panchayati, Mandal level, Mandal Parishad, Jilla level, Jilla Parishad. So this is about the local governments. Now next, Social Statutory Commissions for Protection of Citizen Rights. So this is very very important to the citizens who are living in a country. Why? Because so whenever we have the special commissions to protect our rights, then only we will live peacefully and we will fulfill our and enjoy our rights. So otherwise we do not enjoy our rights really in a country. Now next, social and political movements and environmental struggles in Telangana. So social and political movements are also there in our India. So and environmental struggles. So environmentally we are also facing different problems
that is also comes under the government. So what kind of programs has been launched by the government, how the people are participating in the programs. So all these matters we will learn in social and political movements and environmental struggle in Telangana and emergencies in Telangana. So what kind of emergencies were there? So how the Telangana movement started? So how we fought against the government and how we formed our Telangana on 2nd June 2014. So political parties, non-governmental organizations, NGOs and JSCs, all different community people. So every person were participated in the Telangana movement and finally we achieved our Telangana to rule by ourselves only. So different movements we launched, for example Million March, Pendav, Writer Programs we launched and finally we achieved our Telangana. So contemporary issues in Indian politics, so many issues are there in our country and other countries we have some problems. So we are solving all these problems with peaceful manner because we have exactly a perfect foreign policy. So recently we are also watching on televisions India and China wars, or Pakistan and India wars, like that Nepal and China. All these matters we will discuss in these lessons. And smart governance, so this is also a new concept which is launched in our state, especially when the Telangana formed after we implemented smart governance. So the main aim is the administration must be reach the people in the rural level. That is why different programs and schemes were launched by our Telangana government. And finally, India and the world. So India relations with the world. So how India is continuing its relations with other countries like America, Russia and China, Pakistan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, like that we will discuss all these points in India and the world. So this is about our second year syllabus in brief. So tomorrow we will start our real topic, Indian Constitution and historical context.